Now, I have had conservative values for as long as I can remember, and I have used every vote I've had since I turned 18 to vote for the Conservatives. Not because of some blind loyalty I have for the party, that I do not have, but because they're the only party I've ever felt could bring us closer to the sort of Britain I want to live in. That is a Britain of opportunity and wealth, one where the state does not feel the need to impose itself into every aspect of our lives, one where the government does not meddle in personal affairs, one where people who are not born with much are strongly encouraged to lift themselves up and are given the opportunities to get by in life, to own their own home, to create their own wealth, to, if they can afford and want to, send their kids to a good private school and not be demonised and ridiculed for the hallmarks of success. Now, my roots are as working class as you can get. If we played a game of stereotypical Labour voter bingo, I would win every time. Immigrant, check. Working class upbringing, check. Grew up in a council house, check. Raised by a single parent, check. Ethnic minority, check. Bingo. Or at least that's what a stereotypical Labour voter used to look like. In fact, the reality is the Conservatives are the party of the working class now. Nearly half of working class people voted Tory in the last general election, with a third voting for Labour. And Labour can no longer count on the ethnic minority vote either. And that's all because, slowly, people from disadvantaged backgrounds have increasingly felt that there is more in it for them when the Tories are in power. That's both economically and socially. But every few years, I feel majorly let down. And right now, I feel let down by a Conservative Party that is hell-bent on expanding the long arm of the state into mine and your lives, and their fingers further into mine and your pockets. A Conservative Party with fiscal policies that can barely even pretend to be pro-small business, says the lifeblood of this country, of course. A Conservative Party that has little to offer my generation but bluffing snake oil debt and tears. Now, why would I ever vote Conservative again, some may ask. Well, we have a Labour Party not worthy of the title of Her Majesty's most loyal opposition, for one. The only thing they're loyal to are virtue-signalling champagne socialists and the far-left lunatics pulling strings behind the scenes. Look, at least there's hope for the Conservatives, just about. So will I give in just yet? No, I won't. But I am sure of this. I'm not alone in wanting to send this message to the Conservatives. Read my lips. You are living on borrowed trust.